The following program is brought to you by Kevin Shorey Ministries and our family of friends.
I think I see.
Hey, Justin.
My goodness.
I didn't mean to scare you, but you're looking at something. You know, we got to start the program here.
Yeah, I know. Well, today
is looking for?
It's National Bird Day, Kevin.
Bird Day?
Yeah, so I'm looking for a rare Ozarkian Marshele blackbird.
Inside the studio, huh?
There's
fly in, huh?
Oh, it's rare, Kevin.
It's so rare, I've never heard of it.
Well, yeah, well, I think it's coming now.
Where?
Kevin, look out. What? What?
He fell. Blooper. It's the Kevin Shorey Show. Taped before a live studio audience in the Branson Mill in Branson, Missouri. Today, Kevin's special guest, Pastor John Alarid. And the sometimes funny but always co-host, Justin Aller. And now, through every season, turn to the Kevin Shorey Show. Here's your host, Kevin Shorey. Welcome to the Kevin Shorey Show. Isn't it a great day to serve the Lord? Yes, it is. Come on, let me sing a song. This is from my Time Has Come CD. Well, I've been through the fire, I've been through the flood. Down in the valley, stuck in the mud. I had to look up just to see bottom. If you're looking for stories, brother, I got them. But I ain't gonna give up. I ain't gonna give up on God. Come on. I've been busted and bruised, battered and torn. Walked through the desert, weary and worn. I had me some biscuits. Without any gravy, but in every situation, the hand of God fed me. So I ain't gonna give up. I ain't gonna give up on God. Oh no. The God that I serve can ride on the wind. I've seen him come through time and time again. He's my salvation, my cornerstone, a steady foundation. Be blessed. So I ain't gonna give up. You shouldn't give up on God. Come on, play it, boys. Yeah. Little guitar. Sometimes I may bend, but I know I'm not gonna break. I'm holding on to God with rock solid faith. He promised to show up, so I'll be here waiting. You're wasting your time, so get behind me, Satan, 'cause I ain't gonna give up. I ain't gonna give up on God. No, 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 because the God that I serve, he can ride on the wind. I've seen him come through time and again. He's my salvation, my cornerstone, a steady foundation that I'm building on. Listen, when the going gets tough and the battle is long, the great God Jehovah, he's steady and strong. So I ain't gonna give up.
Hey, it's in the middle of winter, but spring is coming. You need to plan ahead. How do you plan ahead? Get your Kevin Shorey Show t-shirt. It says we're reaching the world. Yes, we are. Your donation of $20 or more for the first t-shirt and $10 for every t-shirt afterwards helps support us and helps us to reach the world. It also helps us to let the world know Jesus is the answer for your world today. And we're back.
Yeah.
Come on.
I love those t-shirts.
Love those t-shirts, but man, that song just gets me pumped up. Ain't gonna give up on God.
Ain't.
God is coming through.
Ain't
even gonna. A few of our shows, we've been saying how right now it doesn't look so good, but we ain't gonna give up on God. And I'll share more on my soapbox, but we're in the new year of 2017, and God's just really blessing us and helping us. And we just need more of the blessing. We need, really, it's God's people.
Yeah.
And if they rally together, there is no force. I think we showed that election time. When God's people really set a mind to it and are praying, something different happens.
Yes.
You know, something good always happens. And so through every season, turn, turn, turn. That's what the announcer said at the beginning. Does anybody know who recorded Turn, Turn, Turn? The original Turn, Turn, Turn. I'll give you a dinner for two at Mr. Gilberti's Italian restaurant. I know you know. Who did Turn, Turn, Turn in the 60s? Anybody know? It's our theme, the Birds.
It's Bird Day.
That's right. It was a group called the Birds.
Bird Day, yes.
Then my dear friend Pam Thumb, she re-recorded it.
Really?
Yeah, in the Top 40 Christian. Anyhow, Dollar, still throwing that out there. Dollar votes.
Yep.
We got the Dollar votes. And
and
we have, if y'all see an empty screen in one time and then a full one, it's because all our shows are kind of mixed up during the but this is what we got so far. But hey, I got a couple of family friends we got to throw a shout out.
Oh,
that's the orange one.
Orange, because?
Because, orange, you glad you became a family of friends. Thank you. And this is my dear friends. They've been a long time before I was ever on TV. Jerry and Carol, Leslie, Arkansas. So Arkansas is thrown out. The only state in
here.
The Bible.
It is.
Noah stepped out of the Arkansas, the rainbow. Okay. There it is. So it's right up there?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, it's up close to us. Okay. And then Leon and Sherry, they're kind of new partners, but they are family of friend members, and they just go above and beyond. They're just a blessing. Oh. Parkersburg, Iowa. So Iowa's getting on the map.
I'm from Iowa, Kevin.
Come on now. We got Iowa.
That's up here towards the middle.
Right in the middle top
northeast.
Of Iowa.
Yeah.
There you go, Parkersburg. Wow. So thank you all for doing that, and we're trying to get the list together to put them more, because really this is going to be almost more than half full if we really got caught up. Thank you for voting the dollar. Thank you for becoming a family, a friend, partner. $33 a month. I'm mixing everything together here, but
I'm
just
so
follow
confused.
Me. No, it's it. But this month we are putting, these are the wrong ones, but we've got
we're picking up
CDs, DVDs. We are giving you a whole basket full, at least a couple, a basket full.
Yeah.
Anyway, no, we are going to put a couple of CD or DV, a book, CD, mix and match. Stuff that we have, all great stuff to bless you. We're going to put it together, and that's why I don't want to show one or the other, because it won't be that one. It's just the collection of books and CDs and DVDs that we have. Plus, I'm throwing in the book.
What?
What do we do? Oh,
Destined
for Hell. Luis Torres was on,
a couple times.
Yes, and a couple times, yeah. And each time he's held up this book, I thought everybody should have this as 2017, just an encouragement for you to witness to people and tell them about the power of God unto salvation. And so we have that, of course, our family prayer Bible. If you give the $50, $33 is what everybody could probably do and start doing it this year.
Yeah.
Make that one of your year's goals. Of course, everything is tax deductible, tax credit you get, because we're a nonprofit organization, 501c3, and through the government, all that stuff, and a partridge in a pear tree. And so, but every month, without you asking, we will send you
to say thank you.
Yes, just to say thank you, a gift. And so that's that, and the coloring book, that's the bonus that goes with that.
Mm-hmm.
But with that, we're throwing in this too. We're just going to
throw
a lot of stuff. Yeah, we're going to do that. And so ask for that book. And of course, there's a silver. We don't talk enough about the power of silver.
Kevin.
Is Gordon on today? Gordon's not on today, but Gordon Pedersen, he should be. Because this is structured silver. This is, they're always... It's always good when you're improving things and trying to make them better. You want to make your better self. You probably threw out some New Year's resolutions, how you're going to have a better self in 2017. But they have a new and improved the silver. You've heard the colloidal silver, the silver solution. This is the sacred structured silver. And you say, well, what does silver do? Well, silver actually builds up your immune system. That's where they get the idea with a silver spoon. When they had a fever, they would put a silver spoon in the mouth of their baby to get its immune system built up. For years, thousands of years, the Greeks, the Egyptians all knew the power of silver, and it's something that God made, and it's natural. This is the most natural one that's been ever been made, also structured so that it's alkaline and not acidic to your body. So this will keep
and
the doctor away.
And sacred with the music, Kevin. I had to sing to so many bottles.
Yeah.
They infused vocals.
Infused it with sacred music because they found that even metals, just like plants,
so
these organisms and minerals actually become more, help me.
It's better performed.
Yeah, just like it just comes alive and does what it's supposed to do. And this is the gel
Jesus
that...
Jesus is...
Yeah, it's already been done. It's already
sealed.
No,
I just improved it more, Kevin.
Did you, though?
Put it on. You'll feel it.
It's supposed to be good singing. But anyway, no. So this is the new and improved structured silver. We'll give you a discount on the book if you'd like. Plus, yes.
Where are you going, Kevin?
I haven't told you this. The inventors of the silver have a brand new book.
What?
About the power of silver.
A new fighting chance?
No, it's not called Fighting Chance. It's a whole different new book.
Oh.
And we're going to send it to you. Those that do silver for the next couple of weeks, we're sending it to you free.
What?
One, two, free. That's right. Yes.
That's a good deal.
So it pays to be a partner, a family, a friend, also the VIP, 333, if you'd like to give them 333, for the generator, for three of them, 1333, all those things, it's to your benefit. So make sure you do that. We want to make sure that you get on board with us. Man, if you're not against us, then hopefully you're for us, let us know. And if you're against us, I pray for you. But if you're for us, come on. Join with us from $1 to $33 a month to the $333, $1333, all different levels. And every time we want to give you a gift to say thank you. Every time we know that you will connect not only to our television program, but you will win souls for the Lord Jesus Christ. That's our goal, to let people know Jesus is the answer to whatever they're going through. And here's somebody who knows about the power of prayer and the power of God unto salvation and the answer that God has for his life. And he's brought one of his church members here or one of the, and they're going to share. And so would you welcome John Alarid to the program? Thank
hey,
you.
Hey, great to be
Thank
here,
Thank you for
Kevin.
Coming back.
Absolutely.
And Damien's on the program. He's part of your organization, part of your ministry.
Yes, that's right.
And but let's get started because, you know, you were here in the middle of just craziness, celebration. The last time we were doing our 100th show, we were just in our 100th show. So you shared the set with, from Hee Haw, Lulu Roman. And it's probably...
That's right. Yeah, I remember that.
I thought, this is the craziest thing I've ever done. And then I remembered Lulu was so deep into drugs, we couldn't even see straight half the program she did on Hee Haw till the Lord saved her and set her free. And I thought... Perfect match because you have a similar story. How did God set you free? What happened? How did he set you up?
Yeah, so, you know, I was, even though I grew up in a Christian home, you know, I got involved in drugs and selling drugs at a young age. And I saw the my family members that were involved in illegal activity. They had the big houses. They, you know, never mind that they were gone for 5 to 7 now and again, you know, the time in prison. But I wanted to be like them, my uncles that, you know what I mean, were doing big things on the streets. And so I got caught up, Kevin. You know, I was doing drugs. I was doing heroin, smoking crack cocaine, and in and out of jail and prison. And finally, in 1998, in a drug deal gone bad, I ended up stabbing a guy outside of a 7-Eleven in Albuquerque, New Mexico.
Wow.
And I was already on the run from the PO. So I said, I need to get out of here because it must be Albuquerque that's the problem because it sure ain't me.
Come on, somebody. Yeah. Just find a different place. A lot of people think, if you move to some place, I'm going to, you know, be different, you know. But I say this all the time. If you're wacky here, you're going to be wacky in Waikiki.
Come on.
No matter where you go, you have to take yourself with you.
That's exactly right. So I took off. I went to Phoenix, and my intention was to go to Mexico. You know, I'm half Hispanic. I speak Spanish. I was dealing drugs with one of the major cartels out of Mexico. And so I figured I would just go to Mexico and beat these charges. And but I went to Phoenix, and I ran across a little recovery, a Christ-centered recovery home by the name of Victory Outreach.
All right.
And
now
that was started by Sonny Argonzoni, who met the Lord. David
Sonny.
Wilkerson. Yeah, David Wilkerson's with Teen Challenge,
which
is where my wife actually met the Lord in Long Island. But so I went, I'd heard people had gotten clean at this program called Victory Outreach. So my intention was not to find Jesus, Kevin. You know, my intention was to get clean so I could stay on the run. And what happened was I went into that little recovery home under an assumed name, and Jesus encountered me.
Come on.
So, I mean, it was life transforming because I had peace. For the first time in my life, I had peace, and also for the first time in my life, I had purpose.
Come on now.
You know, and that was transformational.
Come on,
yeah. You know what I mean? And so I graduated the program, then I directed the program.
Yeah.
Then I went to L.A. to the School of Ministry and went to the Mother Church there in Chino, California, actually in La Puente at the time with Pastor Sonny. And
let me just stop you right here for just a second, because there's people watching, maybe even some that are just addicted so deep. Mm-hmm. They think, okay, you know, you must not have been that bad. How in the world can you just one day be that so addicted that you're running from the law, that you think, you know, everybody else has the problem, to like that? You know, you're back on track, or you know, you're where God wants you to be. The doubters out there, tell them. I mean, what was it like from the darkness into light?
Yeah. So, you know, I was hopelessly addicted. So I was doing about a gram and a half of heroin a day.
Wow.
You know, smoking a quarter ounce of rock or crack cocaine, you know what I mean, every 2 days. So my life got real out of control. There was a time in my life when we were selling lots of drugs and doing big things, you know what I mean? But I just ended up being a hopelessly addicted,
addict,
homeless.
Oh, this is the real deal, folks.
Homeless,
yeah.
You know, and so I remember this one time, just to give you a story of just how bad it had gotten for me. I remember this one morning I woke up and I was at the Budget Hotel in North Albuquerque, North Valley of Albuquerque, and I woke up and I had to get heroin just to get well to make it through the day. And so I walked down to the Economy Inn on 4th and Manal to the Economy Inn, called the connection, lied to them, told them I had money, you know, and so they got there and they ended up fronting me some heroin, but I was so sick from the withdrawals that I couldn't make it back to my hotel room. And I went back, I got some water, and I went back behind a dumpster right there at the gas station on a cardboard box, and I got down and I took my shirt off and I was, you know, I was trying to shoot up dope. And right there, you know, with the stench of the trash and rats running around, I looked up and I said, "What happened to my life?" And it was like I had a prodigal son moment at that time. And although my life didn't change right away, you know what I mean, that was one of those instances where it's like my life was out of control. I didn't need anyone to tell me I needed something to change.
Right.
You know, and so I went through that program. You know what I mean? I went to the School of Ministry in L.A. I went to be a missionary in the Philippines. Man, God moved in the Philippines, in Manila. We started recovery homes there. And what happened was I came back to LAX. And how many know, Kevin, you know that Jesus forgives, right?
He does.
How many know the DA, not so much?
Not
so
much.
You know a little something about that, Damon.
Yeah.
But so I got picked up on those old charges.
Of course,
and to LAX, and I was looking at over 20 years in prison, you know, and went back to Albuquerque fighting the charges. They let me out to fight the charges. And when it came time for sentencing, I backslid. You know, lamentably, this is a sad part of my story, because I went back to my old life like a dog returning to its vomit.
Right.
And it was a very dark season. I remember sitting at cheap hotels on Central Avenue in Albuquerque, New Mexico, putting a gun to my head and wanting to blow my head off, because I had failed everybody. I had failed my family. I'd failed my God, you know, and I just wanted to kill myself. And there was a voice in the back of my head that said, "Why don't you pull that trigger?"
See.
And you know what? And during that time, it was a lot of demonic oppression. Some people would say it was drugs. I believe it was reality. Yeah. You know what I mean? That
the enemy wants to make you think you're a failure and keep you down.
And he comes to steal, kill, and destroy.
So that's
his end game. If he could get me to pull that trigger. By the grace of God, I didn't. And I ended up getting picked up and sentenced to only 8 years in prison.
Wow.
And
it
was a miracle. I got to prison and I was still doing the same thing, Kevin. I was doing drugs and I was bringing in drugs, and I ended up getting busted for suspicion of bringing narcotics into the facility. And so I got put in solitary confinement in level 5.
Wow.
So slammed down, you know, 23-hour lockdown in the prison in Santa Fe.
Wow.
And right there at my lowest. This was my lowest point. I was broken. I was in last place, if any place at all. You know, I had hurt everybody again. I was addicted and in prison. you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I got down on my knees and I said, "Jesus, if you're still there, would you come back into my life? Yes, and I'm here to let you know, Kevin, that for that 5 months I was in solitary confinement, it was like waves of electric liquid love flowing over me.
Praise
my
God,
dungeon was filled with light.
Yeah, no, that's how God operates. And it's a process, but it's not failure to fall. It's failure to not keep getting back up.
That's exactly right.
And you
right.
get up and it'll stick. I mean, have to go. Damien, you know about this. How did you get involved with this recovery center and his church now? But let's mention it first. You're in Springfield?
I'm in Springfield, Missouri. So we planted a City Reach Springfield Church at the seminary chapel, actually, we launched at Evangel University.
Wow, and my old stomping grounds.
So I graduated from AGTS just recently.
Wow, congratulations for that.
Thank you.
And so you come stumbling in, or how does this happen?
Yeah, I actually was incarcerated in Greene County.
Yeah.
And I attended chapel services and stuff there, and pastor came up and spoke to us. And I attended a couple of the services, and as you can tell, Kevin's testimony, you know, is pretty powerful. And people in jail and in positions, you know, like I've been in and stuff, you know, really can relate to somebody like pastor and kind of look up to pastor, you know. And
amen.
So he mentioned that he was starting a Hope Home program, a discipleship program. I just turned 30 this year, and for the past 15 years, I've had a pretty drug addicted, violent life, you know. And
what were you in jail for? Or what did?
I got a Class A violent crime and 3 C's.
Yeah.
And so I'm looking at some pretty serious time, actually. And pastors helped me through the whole process, you know. And
come on.
When I left the chapel that day, service at Greene County, after hearing pastor speak, I went back to my cell, and I was like, man, you know, this guy's been through a lot of stuff. You know, he's been through a lot of stuff, and, you know, look where he's at today.
Amen.
You know, and I've always had a relationship with the Lord, you know, as far as a personal relationship with talking, but I've never been so strong in my faith as what I am today.
Yeah.
The judge let me out to go to this program, and I've
been
in it for a little over 3 months now.
Yeah.
And, man, there's just the changes that I see in myself.
Come on, praise
now
God.
Compared to before, like, for example, I go and I pick my kids up. I have 2 children, and I love my children to death, a 6-year-old and a 3-year-old. And opposed to them used to seeing me running the streets and having people come over
come
all the
on,
time
man.
And doing things of that sort, they now see me getting them for church and going to church. They see
come
me answering
on.
Altar calls.
Isn't that
calls.
Great, folks? Come on.
Answering
I just,
altar
it
calls.
It blesses me so much.
And not just my children, my family, my mother, my father. Yeah. You know, my father was involved with motorcycle gangs and did time in the feds, and he's at church service every week now.
Praise God.
And the Hope Home program, something that it also, this discipleship program's really changed. Like when we have problems in the house, you know, sometimes if there's a problem, say there's an argument or something, used to, you know, before, you know, things would be resolved differently. But we get together and we pray now.
Amen.
You know what I'm saying? We pray
I'm
about
sure
things
they were
and
resolved
we work
differently
situations
before.
Out.
Yes.
Right, exactly. So,
and you've been clean from drugs and all this?
Yes,
for,
absolutely.
For
yes.
at least 3 months, you said?
Yeah, for at least 3 months.
Yeah,
yes.
That's awesome. And people can call maybe. Maybe somebody in this area, you know,
absolutely.
Would like to come. They can come and call or.
Yeah,
or
they, so they can contact us through our website, springfield.cityreachnetwork.org, and just go to contact us. And so right now we're at capacity at the Hope Home, and we have a waiting list. So we want to get another men's Hope Home going. And
let's
actually
pray for that.
Come, and this month, January of 2017, we're going to start our women's home. So we're fundraising to start
God.
Our first women's home. So there's a great need for a women's discipleship
Amen.
Home, too.
Thank you, John, for being faithful to the Lord and not giving up when the enemy wanted to have you and take you out, and you didn't. Thank you, and thank you for coming on, Damien. It's not
thank
easy
Kevin.
To share this stuff publicly, for sure. But God has given us that power. And there's those watching. Maybe they're just strung out on their out of their mind.
Yeah.
They need some hope. They need a word. Would you look in your camera? Just you got like 1.5 minutes or so. Just pray them through right now.
So right now where you're at, I just want to ask you, if you meet one of those two criteria, you've never met Jesus, or at one time you were living for him and you don't know him, and you want to surrender your life to Christ, just repeat after me. Say, dear Jesus.
Dear Jesus.
Forgive me.
Forgive me.
I'm a sinner.
I'm a sinner.
I need a Savior.
I need a Savior.
I believe.
I believe.
You're the Son of God.
You're the Son of God.
You came to this earth.
Came to this earth.
Born of a virgin.
Born of a virgin.
Lived a sinless life.
Lived a sinless life.
And died on the cross.
Died on the cross.
For my sin.
For my sin.
And then you resurrected.
And then you resurrected.
On the third day.
On the third day.
And you're now at the right hand of the Father.
Now you're at the right hand of the Father.
And you sent your Spirit.
And you sent quench your spirit.
Fill me with the Spirit.
Fill me with the Spirit.
Fill me with boldness.
Fill me with boldness.
In Jesus' name.
Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. If you prayed that prayer, come on. Let us know. We want to pray with you, help you any way we can. We'll hook you up with John and his ministry, especially if you're hearing this in the Ozarks area. As I know, we're every day on Channel 27 here in the Ozarks, but we go all around the nation. We know there's help. We're throwing out the lifeline. If you want that help, grab a hold of it. But you must make the choice. You say, oh, I got to change this. You make, and I told him to bring my soapbox because I'm just going to end right here on the soapbox. Y'all can help me preach, but I'm telling you, you put the preach in me. I'm ready to stand up, but I got to sit down or they'll just be my belly preaching. But the answer is found in Jesus. You say, I got to fix this. I got to change this. No, you make the choice. God will make the change. You could never make the change on your own. You could never set yourself free from drugs. That's obvious because you haven't. You couldn't set yourself free from pornography, yourself free. You couldn't set yourself free from alcohol. Whatever it is that the enemy is holding you down with, the only one that can set you free is Christ Jesus. And so you need to accept him and put on the whole armor. Don't turn tail and run. My friend Josh told me this and it reminded me this. It says in Ephesians 6:10, finally, be strong in the Lord and the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God so that you can be able to stand against the things of the enemy. If you got the whole armor, the armor's in the front, so don't turn around. Keep going forward. Forget the things that are behind you and go forward in Christ Jesus today. We're going forward. We need your help today. I've made this announcement not on every show, but I'm getting on this show to let you know, honestly, truthfully, totally, we have got to have your help, or these will be our final shows that you'll be able to watch. So please help and pray with the best, largest gift that you can and help us in any way, especially pray for us so that we can tell the world Jesus is the answer for your world today. See you next week.
This amazing solar generator is easy to use, portable, and affordable. Keep one in your car for emergencies, camping trips, or tailgate parties. The included solar panel collects free sunlight and stores extra energy in its lithium batteries. Get one for your house to charge your phone, computers, or run your lights to lower your electric bill. Just a few years ago, a generator like this would cost thousands of dollars. Today, just $499. It's 100% tax deductible, and your satisfaction is guaranteed. Call now at 209-44-KEVIN. We'll include two LED lights, AC charger, USB connectors for your smartphone and tablets, one solar panel, and for a limited time, free shipping. For more information, visit kevinshorey.com or call us at 209-44-KEVIN. Thank you for your continued support.
The world-famous Branson Mill at 3300 North Gretna Road, where art meets entertainment, featuring the Corner Store Studio, friendly staff, hundreds of shops, demonstrations, crafts, snacks, classes, artwork, fun for all ages, the Treehouse Cafe. All under one roof at the world-famous Branson Mill, where art meets entertainment.
The preceding program was brought to you by Kevin Shorey Ministries and our family of friends.